over in Black Lake. Did you guys text each other or something?
Good evening. Thank you so much for joining us. My name is Dr. Higgins. I'm the director of bands here at Rowan, and we're thrilled to be performing this concert for you this evening. You may think it's strange or that it feels weird to be up here with no audience in the hall, but I assure you, we feel nothing but extreme excitement and gratitude to be able to play tonight. This is our first concert of the year. It's actually our first concert in a year. So a huge thank you to all the staff, and the student workers who are helping making this performance possible. A huge thank you to all of my colleagues and the administrators who've helped make this semester possible, and all this live, safe, in-person playing and learning. We have two groups this evening. The Symphonic Band will be on around 8 o'clock. But first, this is the Rowan University Concert Band, conducted by Dr. Mark Kadetsky. And the march at the top of this program is not on the printed program. But I'll let Mark tell you more about that after they perform this first piece. Again, thank you so much for joining us, and let's give a big at-home, on-your-couch round of applause for the Rowan University Concert Band and their conductor, Dr. Mark Kadetsky.
Good evening. This is not on the program, and I want to echo Dr. Higgins' welcome to those of you at home, and hope you're having a relaxed, wonderful time, and we're very excited to bring you some live band music for the first time in a while, for a while. So we couldn't very well have our first band concert forever on March the 4th without marching forth with the Southampton March that we'll be opening our portion of the program with today. So sit back and enjoy as the Rowan Concert Band opens with Robert Sheldon's Southampton March. Our next selection is entitled, as you may or may not see in the program, Two British Folk Songs by Elliot Doborgo. It was written in 1993, and it's been a relatively long-lasting staple in band literature. And we're going to do something a little different with this, if I may indulge you for a moment, about the educational portion of this. In normal, precedented times, we would have our conducting students working with bands that we would bring in throughout the semester and give our Rowan students an opportunity to conduct a live ensemble before their first job interview or their first student teaching experience. And unfortunately, that was not the case. So to try to replicate that as best we could and keep our Rowan students as far ahead of the curve as we can, two of our students tonight are going to be conducting the two British folk songs. So you will be hearing this twice. For your own entertainment, but also for the educational value for our conducting students to give them some experience so that the first time they're conducting a band is not at their first job or their student teaching. And the first student that we're going to be bringing up is Mr. Joe Elmo. Joe is a very talented young man from Toms River School District, who's actually a piano major, but also is very proficient on the saxophone and the tuba. And he'll be conducting our first pass through of the two British folk songs by Elliot Doborgo. So please give us a warm welcome from home for Mr. Joe Elmo and his conducting debut, our student conductor with the Rowan Concert Band. So it's like deja vu all over again. For our second rendition or run-through performance of this piece, we're going to be bringing up a music education new major, Mr. Oscar Madrigal. Oscar hails from the Jackson School District, and he is a low brass specialist. He performs extensively on trombone and euphonium and tuba, and also keeps busy with drum corps activities and high school marching bands. And I believe he is all set up and ready to go. So again, the Elliot Delborgo two British folk songs with our student conducting experience for Mr. Oscar Madrigal. Enjoy. And again, my congratulations and kudos to Oscar and Joe, and if their parents or friends are watching at home, congratulations to you as well. And we're gonna close our portion of the program with a piece by Randall Standard, so very relatively new piece called Metro Dance, and it was inspired by a visit, one of the composer's visits to New York City during a much busier time with lights and traffic and people and hustling and bustling, and it was meant to convey all those feelings and sights and scenes and emotions. So the Rowan Concert Band will end their portion of the program before we bring out our symphonic band and Dr. Higgins with Randall Standage's Metro Dance. So exciting, almost 30 years as a band director, my first live stream pandemic concert in the books. Very happy for these students, I'm very proud of them, I'm very grateful for them. It has not been easy, but it has been fun and it has been worthwhile. And we'll be exiting the stage and bring you a equally exciting and informative program, as always, from Dr. Joseph Higgins and the Rowan University Symphonic Band. Thank you very much, and we're gonna see you again April 25th. Thank you.
All right, and our last piece this evening is really three songs. The songs Down by the Riverside, Deep River, and I Want to Be Ready, all arranged famously by H.T. Burley and then adapted for ensemble by composer Steve Danube, the same composer as our first piece. It's a great opportunity for us to get to play this excellent music that wasn't originally written for our medium, but that works very, very well. So we hope that we're bringing justice to these beautiful, beautiful songs. The third provides an opportunity for some of our students to improvise, but all of them, I think you'll see, have excellent stylistic opportunities and really, really beautiful phrasing. And I mention this because I have a lot of friends watching who are middle and high school band directors, and I really encourage you to check this piece out in particular because we've really enjoyed working on it. So I thank you very much for joining us this evening. Please check out now the registration for a concert same time next week on the 11th at 7:30. The Wind Ensemble will perform a full program, again here on stage to a virtual audience. It's a thrill to be making music once again live with one another. And I'm just very, very grateful to the students for their professionalism and passion to make this happen. So thank you very much for giving us someone to play for. And we hope to see you here in person sometime soon. This is Three Spirituals by H.T. Burley.